students, in previous video we have discussed poem A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. Today we will discuss textual questions and the questions which are asked in CBSE board examination, and that important questions today we will discuss. So listen carefully, and when you are listening, open textbooks, so it will be useful for you. First question, textual question, think it out. List the things of beauty mentioned in the poem. Now we have to think about the original poem, and in that, where that things of beauty, that list, how can you find out the list? So here, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from dark spirits. So here you can think about that there are some shape of beauty which will help you to come out from that negativity, and then author started the things of beauty. So one by one here it is referred in that. First one, sun, the moon, trees, old and young, sprouting of shady boon, then daffodils, clear rills, musk roses. So here at least whatever the names here it is given of things of beauty, that if you will mention, then your answer will be good. So no problem will occur. Then list the things that cause suffering and pain. So poet, in the beginning poet is explaining the beauty of the nature, then the advantages of nature, and then suddenly the mood of the poem it changed, and in that mood poet mentioned all that things which are causes of suffering and pain. So here I will refer the stanza. Spite of despondence, of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over-darkened ways made for our search. So here, spite of despondence, that disappointments, or whatever the things, that nervousness, due to some problem, maybe not understanding our role, not understanding the task, what we are doing, why we are doing, and that disappointment, it would be the cause of the suffering and pain. Then next, inhuman death of noble nature. Suppose you are following the path of noble nature, then the disappointments may not come, but if you are following the inhuman way to live your life, then there would be fear in your mind. Your inner mind would always tell you that whatever you are doing, that is not good. So it is very important that inhuman task we should avoid. It is the cause of suffering and pain. Then the gloomy days. So here the gloomy days refers to the task or deeds which we are regularly doing, and that we are doing it for so many days, and that things it would change into the gloomy days because you are not understanding that why you are doing that, and that negativity, sometime someone may kill also for the sake of money, and again that nervousness, again that fear. So, or in that nervousness, someone may do suicide also. So all that things which you are thinking, that the gloomy days here refers to the days of the depression, days of nervousness, disappointments, or the task which you are doing, but that task are not good for the humanity. Of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways, so unhealthy practices, whatever you are doing, that also it would cause you the pain and suffering, and over darkened ways, that the ways which are not good to follow, means so many things, smuggling or taking drugs or so many that unhealthy ways or over darkened ways which are not good for the society, means some they are joining terrorist groups or those who are not good for the society, such type of task deeds they are doing, that are the things here it is mentioned as a over darkened ways and some unhealthy practices that will surely cause the pain and suffering. So all that things in a short manner you have to write. Then next question, what does the line, therefore are we breathing a flowery band to bind us to earth, suggest to you? So here in the poem, that line it is given, earlier 4 or 5 lines here poet expressed that a thing of beauty is a joy forever, and then its loveliness increases, it will not pass into nothingness, and how it is the beauty it keeps keep quiet power for us, and it is very good that when we are in the company of the nature, we will feel better and we will have a nice sleep. Then dream means our health and the quiet breathing, all that things first poet here explain, and then poet use this line, that is, therefore on every morrow are we breathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. So if the beautiful things gives us happiness, or when we are in the company of the thing of beauty which are exist in the nature or on this earth planet, so are we breathing, are we decorating that beauty, are we helping the nature, or are we contributing, are we conserving the things, means the wildlife, then forest, means deforestation nowadays we can observe, right, for the selfish behavior human being, we are not doing the task which is important for the environment, but we are selfish, and nearby the specialty cities nowadays we are not observing that we are planting the trees in that phase, means nowadays smart city, all means whenever we are thinking to set up the smart city, but the requirement of the environment, all that things, very few people they are aware about that, and they are not doing that task. So here, on every morrow are we breathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. So here this are we breathing, here in a question mood here poet is asking that are we doing something for the nature every morrow, means every morning, that are we contributing to the nature, at least to water the plant or the things, whatever you can do, or reduce the pollution, or what means to use the water properly, because water scarce, so many problems are there, and that small problems at your individual level, means suppose garbage or whatever the things which are harmful for the human being and the nature, that are we taking care of that? So are we breathing? This question it is asked, so I think you can understand this. Then what makes human beings love life in spite of having troubles and suffering? What makes human being love life in spite of having troubles and sufferings? So here poet mentioned that spite of discordance, poet mentioned here the gloomy days, inhuman death of noble nature, poet mentioned that unhealthy ways, over darkened ways. So all that thing, sufferings, nervousness, depression, or whatever the negativity, it is there in your mind, the burden of the task, or whatever the things, due to that you are following the wrong path. So in spite of that, suppose you will follow the path of the nature, then here the line it is given. In spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall. Pall means the cover of that negativity or that wrong deeds from our dark spirits. Whatever the dark spirits means, the negative task, wrong task, whatever we are doing, we are following the path of that inhuman task, that it will vanish, or it will help you to vanish that task. So this is very important. Here we have to mention some names, such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting shady boon, daffodils, musk roses, or quail rills. So all that, share some examples given, specimen examples given. There are many things of beauty, or so many things are there on this earth planet that will give you the everlasting joy, or a thing of beauty is a joy forever. So here in the first line itself, poet mentioned that. So if you will understand that, if you will go in the company of such type of thing of beauty, you will have again the feeling of joy, understanding yourself. Once you will understand yourself, once you will realize yourself, when you will introspect yourself, slowly what will happen? You will follow the path of positivity, optimism. So this question, I think you can understand. Why is grandeur associated with mighty deed? So in explanation also we have discussed that mighty deed, it is why it is compared with the word here it is given, that is magnificence, grandeur. So here grandeur meaning is magnificent. Why that mighty deeds? Because the mighty deeds, their contribution to the world, it gives us inspiration. When we are reading their biographies, their works, when we are analyzing, we are observing that they too have such type of problems, but they overcome that problems and contributed to the world. So we too have problems. How can we decrease that intensity of the problem? And when we will go in the nature, or when we will read such type of books, surely what will happen, that we will also feel happy, and that happiness will help you towards the success. Means when you are happy, you will be successful. So like that here, such type of small things, but that thing will be very helpful for you. Then, do we experience things of beauty only for a short moment, or do they make a lasting impression on us? So here, the thing of beauty, it is not the temporary. So I will refer the lines. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. So this word is important. It will never pass into nothingness. It will be everlasting. Everlasting source of the joy. Joy forever. So this is the eternal joy, which it will never fade. So this answer will be positive, that the thing of beauty will give you the everlasting joy, like an endless fountain of immortal drink. At the end also it is mentioned. Then, what image does Keats use to describe a beautiful thing of the earth? So here, what image? At the ending of the poem, that image thinks it is an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from heaven spring. So how is that image? It is the image of a fountain that is endless and from heaven's brink. from the that corner, like elixir, the things are coming and pouring unto us. Miss the beauty of the nature. The vibrations in the nature are positive. And when you will observe that beauty of the nature, you can understand that I, whatever the things I am doing, it is for the society. When you are doing for the society, that love which you are creating towards the society, you will also get that same thing back. So help others, think in the manner which will help you and your society, your family, and simultaneously to a country, and finally the whole earth will get that beauty. Means your beautiful things, your good thoughts, good ideas will always help others. Then next question, that what image does Keats use to describe the beautiful bounty of the earth that now only we have discussed in that and endless fountain of immortal drink. Textual questions over. Now we will discuss some questions which are asked for the board examination. Short answer questions. What is the source of the endless fountain and what is its effect? So CBSC Foreign 2010 and 2011, two times this question it is asked. So it is endless fountain refers to the beauty of the nature, and this beauty of the nature, it is compared with the endless fountain. And then what is its effect? So what would be the effect of that endless fountain or the beauty of the nature? That the impact of the nature on our mind, it is soothing effect. And when we are going in the nature, what will happen? Our negative thoughts will slowly vanish from our mind, and the positivity will fill, and we will feel happy, and in that happiness good thoughts will come, negative thoughts will go away, and that positive thoughts, optimistic thoughts will help others to understand you, and you will also understand others, and that mutual understanding will help each other, and this earth will be good. Then what is the message of the poem A Thing of Beauty? So here A Thing of Beauty, the message it is given that the nature is the source of everlasting joy, and that joy will never fade. And this poem is reflecting that when we are in the company of the nature, we are getting that sound sleep, quiet breathe, and we are feeling happy, peaceful life, and that is everyone is required. So everyone now, they are purchasing so many things for the happiness, but the real happiness is the nature. Then one more thing here, message is given that when you will go in the company of the nature, in that some thing of beauty like sun, moon, or the daffodils, musk roses, or when you will refer the autobiographies or biographies you will read, you, that great deeds, that great contribution will help you, and you can change that inhuman task, or you can change the mood of disappointments into the positivity. So this type of multiple ways you can describe this question. Then how is a thing of beauty a joy forever? CBSC Delhi 2012, this question it is asked. So we have now only discussed that question is how a thing of beauty joy forever. In the beginning itself, a thing of beauty is a joy forever, because this, the thing of beauty, it is everlasting. It is the eternal beauty. It will never pass into nothingness. So it will be continued. Whenever you will go in the company of the nature, it will not happen like that in the morning or afternoon or the evening. But whenever you go, that thing of beauty will always give you the happiness, and that is not a kind of selfish thing. With a selfless view, everything you will get. You just observe the tree, maybe it is old or the young, but you will get the oxygen. That tree will not ask you whether you are rich. That tree will not ask you, are you from which caste? Or that tree will not ask you that, are you from which country? But that tree will give you the best whatever that tree can give. So this is the thing, that whenever, wherever you go, it is not like that, that you will go in another country and that nature will say, no, you are not from our country, you are foreigner, so we will not support you. The thing, it is not like that. The nature always gives us the respect. Nature always gives us the things which it is there. So like that, whenever we are having such type of differences, then go in the nature and ask to the nature, then you will get that answers, because that time your mind will be fresh, your hatred, jealousy, or all that things will be less within you. Then describe any three things of beauty mentioned in the poem, a thing of beauty. So here three things in that, the sun, the moon, trees, old and young, at least three you can give. According to Keats, what moves the pain of suffering away from human beings? So year 2016, this question, an earlier question, it is asked in All India level 2012 and 2013. So question is easy. In this also, the same thing, what moves the pain and suffering away from the human being? So a thing of beauty will help you. Means the same answer we have to give. The moon, the sun, the trees, old and young, or shady boons, or clear reels, daffodils, and the mighty deer. All that examples you can provide in this answer. What does Keats consider as an endless fountain of immortal drink, and why does he call its drink immortal? So here, in this question, the beauty of the nature, it is everlasting, it is endless, endless source of joy. So here, endless fountain, this is endless source of joy. So there is a comparison. And when you will go in the company of the nature, you will observe that joy, and you will feel from internally that now the purification process started, and your mind will purify, and you will enjoy the real happiness of the earth. So here, in that way, you can answer this question. What does a thing of beauty do for us? CBSE Delhi 2015, this question is asked. So, what that thing of beauty is doing for us? It is keeping the quiet bower for us. Means we feel comfort in the company of the nature. When we will go in the company of the nature, we will have very nice sound sleep or the dreams, and our health will be good. And quiet breathing, and that breathing is very important. When our breathing will disturb, then you will understand nowadays in corona that breathing, whenever there is a problem, everyone is scared. So this quiet breathing is very important, and it will be only available in the company of the nature. It will not be available in four walls. So you can explain so many examples. We have already discussed so many things. So mention any four things of the beauty that adds joy to our life. So here, think of beauty in that any four things repeated questions are asked. 2015, all India level, this question is asked. The same answer, the moon, the sun, the trees in that, old and young, or daffodils, clear rails. The same the list here. You have to mention any two things which cause pain and suffering. All India level 2015, this question is asked. The spite of discordance means the disappointments, the gloomy days, over darkened ways, inhuman death of noble nature. Such type of things, whichever are the main cause of the suffering and pain, that you can write. Which objects of nature does Keats mention as the source of joy in his poem A Thing of Beauty? All India level 2015, the same answer, that same list of the thing of beauty, here it is also expected. How can mighty day be a thing of beauty? CBSE Delhi 2017, it is asked. So inspirational leads, their inspiration, their contribution, their philosophy, their struggle, whatever it is mentioned, you will study that. And you will not do the same mistake. And whatever their guidance, whatever their contribution, suggestions, and their positive views will help you, and you will feel fresh. Again, you will have that motivation which will help you in future. Then next, in the hot season, how do men and the beasts get comfort? So here, in the hot season, whenever you will go in the company of the nature, or here it is mentioned that clear, when we are observing the nature, there are some things. So I will refer that line. And clear rills, that for themselves a cooling covert make against the hot season. So this line, it is perfect thing for that. That even though any animal or a human being would go there in that hot season, that clear rills will give you the comfort against that hot season. Then, how does Keats show his unhappiness with his fellow human beings? So here, the negative things in that spite of discordance, gloomy days, inhuman death of noble natures, where their deeds are wrong. So how, when we are doing something wrong, always our mind will reflect, you have done wrong, you have done wrong. And that fear of that thing, the pressure of the wrong things will always hit you, and then your mind will unhappy, that sadness will lurk in your mind. And again, that sadness may sometimes change into the depression, and someone may follow the path of suicide as well. So here, how does Keats define a thing of beauty? So here, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. In the first line, it is given, and again some more expressions in that. First, its loveliness increases. So this line also you have to write, its loveliness increases. And one more, it will never pass into nothingness. So, and how is the thing of beauty? It is mentioned at the ending of the poem, an endless fountain of immortal dream. So some such type of lines, if you will write in the answer, your answer will be very impressive. So think in that manner. What troubles and sufferings do human beings face in life? So here, troubles and suffering in that lack of noble nature, lack of understanding, or the wrong deeds, because of that we are not happy, and that unhappiness will cause the problem, and that problem will create again, means day by day, when one task we will do wrong, and for that wrong task again we will do something wrong, and then that chain of the wrong things will continue, and for one wrong or one false thing we will again do something wrong. So we have to break that chain of doing something in a wrong way, inhuman way. Then that gloomy days will change into the brightness, and then your days will be happy. That happiness will come in your mind. Okay, so I feel that you have understood all the questions which I have discussed. Read question carefully, whatever the questions you will get in so many reference books or different question papers, previous year question papers. Read poem carefully, each and every line, and I hope that you will not have any problem. So keep your study going on and help each other whenever if you have any problem, because this nature teaches us so many good things. And whenever you will have time, go in the nature and feel, and especially our Konkan area is the bounty of the happiness, or we can say it is the endless fountain of immortal drink. So taste it and be happy.